I've been in the Valley for 16 years, but I started volunteering before that. I think it's always been kind of in my heart to do the right thing and help people and different organizations. But here in the Valley, there are so many different nonprofits and organizations to be involved with, and I find myself either being called upon by people I know or just with my heart. And so I have been the keynote speaker for Shelter from the Storm twice. I was also on their auxiliary board and their board of directors. It's just something that's really dear to me, and it's something that's so prevalent. Shelter from the Storm came to be a part of my life because I was in an abusive relationship for about 5 years. Towards the end of the relationship, my best friend at the time entered me in the Miss Orange County pageant, which was just the craziest idea because here I had no confidence, but I went through with the pageant. I ended up winning, and one of the judges came up to me and said, "Do you know why you won?" And I was like, "No." And she said, "The reason you won is because you were just being you." And that was like life-changing for me because I thought to myself, I'm gonna be unapologetically me from here on out. I teach my kids the same thing, that you always stay true to yourself. And if you do that, everything else falls in place. I've been part of the United Way. Through the pandemic, it was really fun for me because I was one of the bedtime story volunteers. I'd lock myself up in my home office and read to the kids every couple of days, and so that was really fun.
I'm Cindy, and I'm here with United Way of the Desert doing our Friday night bedtime story. Grumpy corn! How can you be a grumpy unicorn?
They had the Summer Special Olympics, and I thought, oh my gosh, that would be so great to be a part of. And so I went through the training, went in, and I was a liaison for a gymnastics team. I had one athlete who was my little friend for the day, and she came over and sat on my lap. She asked me, "Can you rub my feet?" I mean, it was just so sweet the whole day. It was just really impactful because they were competitive, but they weren't mean, and they really wanted everyone to succeed. And I took that away and thinking, that's how everybody should be. There's enough business to go around, there's enough awards to go around, you know, all of that, that we should all be supportive of one another, because that's kind of what it's all about.
It is an absolute honor to be celebrating Cindy Burrison tonight for everything that she is and does in our community and beyond. What she's doing for the community and what she has in store for the community in the future is really nothing less than remarkable. It's a pleasure to celebrate you. Congratulations, Cindy. We love you.
The Children's Discovery Museum has always been near and dear to my heart. I came on in December as the interim executive director and then full-time in March. We have about 85,000 visitors a year, and about 35 to 40,000 are local kids and families. I think it's a great place for them to learn and grow, but also to imagine what their future might be like. With the museum being closed, we're not serving the public the way we ordinarily would be. So I created an initiative called Little Kids Big Impact. The goal is twofold. First of all, what we're doing is partnering with a different nonprofit every month and doing a tangible goods drive. But the second part, and the part that was really important to me, is teaching our kids to be philanthropic. I think it's really important because that's who is shaping our world and our community here locally. And the sooner you get them involved and engaged and they understand the need, I think the long-term benefits of that are so amazing. They can make a difference, that something as simple as their word makes a difference, that their heart makes a difference and their intention makes a difference. I think they will remember that forever. And it's really going to create this whole little army, if you will, of do-gooders around the community. And I think that's just really a responsibility that I take seriously. What keeps me going? I think my family for sure. And just making a difference. I think I have come through a lot in my life, and I never look at myself as a victim, because I'm not. But I think that it's given me the opportunity to show other people how you can come out of adversity and be happy. And I, honest to goodness, every day I do choose joy every single day. I love my life. I love my husband, my kids, my family, my community, my job, everything. I just really have so much joy in my heart. And if I can help other people feel that way and spread that joy, then that's what keeps me going every day.